Welcome back, guys. In this video, we're gonna start defining the velocity and the acceleration in the kinematics of a rectilinear motion. So guys, what is a velocity? I know by definition that the velocity is the change of the displacement of any particle with respect to time. All right? And I know, guys, from physics that I can have two velocities, what is called the average velocity and the instantaneous velocity. So the average velocity should be delta S, if I'm talking about the algebraic form, because as I know from the previous video, S is the algebraic form of the position vector over delta T. This is V average. If I want to find V average in vector form, I have absolutely to use delta R, because R is the vector position over delta T. Now, if I need to find the instantaneous velocity, I should, of course, take this V average and find its limit when delta T goes to zero, which means when T prime is very close to T, which means, guys, if I differentiate R over dt, and this is in vector form, so which means v instantaneous in vector form will be dr over dt, and v instantaneous in scalar form should be ds over dt. Now, I know, guys, that if this particle is not moving, which means ds is equal to zero, or which means delta s is equal to zero, then v is equal to zero. If V instantaneous is equal to zero, which means this particle is not moving, then I have to go back to the statics case because, in fact, this particle is at rest. Now, what if this particle is moving and I need to find the sine of this velocity? Guys, I know that dt is always positive. Dt is a positive value. Now, how to find the sine of V instantaneous? It should be, of course, the same sine of ds. And I know, guys, from the previous video, that displacement is positive if the particle is at the right of its initial position, which means, guys, ds is positive if this particle is moving to the right, and ds is negative if this particle is moving to the left. And this will also be applied to V instantaneous because it has the same sign as ds. All right? So V is positive if this particle is moving to the right, and V is positive if this particle is moving to the left. Now, what is speed? Guys, by convention, speed is the magnitude of velocity. So by definition, guys, speed is the magnitude of velocity. So speed is not a vector parameter, and it's always positive because this is the magnitude of the velocity. However, guys, if I ask you to find the average speed, it's very different than the average velocity. What is the average speed? The average speed, in fact, is st. Remember st? St is the whole distance traveled by this particle over delta t. So this is the average speed, all right? It is st over delta t. If I ask you to find the average velocity, it is delta s over delta t. So guys, please recognize the difference between the average speed and the average velocity. The average speed is always greater or equal to the average velocity. It is st over delta t. And st, guys, is the whole distance traveled, as we said in the previous video. It is the whole distance traveled from p to p prime. So this is st. While delta s does not depend on the path followed at all. It is OP prime minus OP, or S prime minus S. So here it is negative because P prime is at the left side of P, or because the particle is moving to the left. All right? Now, what about the acceleration? acceleration, guys, is also the derivative of the velocity with respect to time. And this is if I am talking about the instantaneous velocity. And this is very similar to the velocity, the instantaneous velocity and the average velocity. Now, in the acceleration, the instantaneous acceleration is, of course, the derivative of the velocity with respect to time. And the average acceleration is delta v over delta t. Now, what can I say that this acceleration is positive and this acceleration is negative? I know, guys, that dt is also positive, right? So A is equal to dv over dt. Now, if I am talking about the vector form, I should put here a vector sign and here a vector sign, right? If I am talking about the algebraic form, so this is A and this is dv over dt. Now, I know, guys, that dt is positive, which means, guys, that A is always the same sign as dv. If dv is positive, then A is positive. And then, in this case, I can say that this is an accelerated motion. Okay. So what does this mean? What does dv positive mean? dv positive means that v is increasing. If v is increasing, then this is an accelerated motion, then A is positive. A is positive in scalar form means A in vector form is a positive vector. What does this mean? A is a positive vector means that A is in the positive direction of my axis, which is here S. So if A is positive, then if this is my S, this should be A. It is in the positive direction. Now, what if dv is negative? dv is negative means v is decreasing. It doesn't mean, guys, that v is negative. It means that v is decreasing. Alright, v is decreasing means A is negative, means that this is called a decelerated motion. What does this mean? A decelerated motion means that A is a negative vector. A is a negative vector means that if this is S, so this belongs to A negative. If this is S, guys, A is a negative vector, which means this is A. So guys, please don't be confused. This A doesn't mean that the particle is moving to the left. No. This A means that this motion is decelerated. Decelerated means that the velocity is decreasing. It doesn't mean that V is negative. V could be positive, but decreasing. And then in this case, A is negative. Like this example here, guys. All right? So I'm going to start from the first beginning, which is to find delta S. How to find delta S? Delta S is equal to what? To OP prime minus OP, all right? So delta S is positive in this case. It is OP prime minus OP, which means delta S here is positive. The displacement is positive because, in fact, guys, P is moving to the left. So that's why delta S is positive. Now, what about V? V is also positive. V is equal to dS over dt, all right? V is always positive, as you can see from this figure. So both of these two vectors, V and V prime, they are in the positive direction of S. They are positive, all right? So they are positive. In fact, P, the particle, is moving to the right, so they are positive. However, guys, if you take a look on V here, this vector and this vector, you can find that V is decreasing. V is decreasing in its magnitude means that A, which is equal to dv over dt, is negative. And this means, guys, that this is a decelerated motion. Although the velocity at P and P prime are both positive, but A is negative, and this means that A is going to the left. So if A as a vector is going to the left, which means it is negative, this doesn't mean that the motion is to the left, all right? The motion could be to the right, but it is decelerating, and that's why A is negative to the left. Now, what if A is equal to zero? So after finding the derivative of the velocity with respect to time, I found that A is equal to zero. What does this mean? A is equal to zero means that the velocity is not varying with respect to time, which means this velocity is equal to a certain constant value, which means, guys, I am at rest. My motion is not accelerated or decelerated. I am at rest means, guys, I am in statics, at equilibrium, which means, guys, that the first law of Newton could be applied and that the sum of forces is equal to zero. You can apply the second law. Sum Ff is equal to ma. And then, since A is equal to zero, you can go back to the first law, which means sum of forces is equal to zero. And this means, guys, that dynamics includes statics. But statics is a case, a particular case of dynamics, where A is equal to zero, because this is a constant velocity motion, which means I don't have acceleration, or V is always equal to zero, which means I am at rest. Now, why did I say that V is always equal to zero? Because in fact, guys, I can have at a certain instant a zero velocity, but this is still an accelerating motion. So guys, if let's say at time t, V was equal to 3 meters per second, and then, as we know from physics, the kinetic energy and the potential energy are exchanged so that at t is equal, let's say, to 2, V is equal to 0. Right? So, this doesn't mean, guys, that since I have a zero velocity at a certain instant, that this body is in statics or this body is at rest. No. It has an acceleration, and this acceleration is basically negative because the velocity is decreasing, all right? So even if I have a zero velocity at a certain instance, this doesn't mean that I am in statics or that the velocity or that the acceleration is equal to zero. The acceleration is equal to zero only if the velocity is constant and it is not changing with respect to time. Now, in the next video, guys, we're going to cover or we're going to derive the equations of kinematics. Thank you.